In tonight's medical alert, severe aortic stenosis is the narrowing of the aortic heart valve, which interferes with the body's blood flow. Now, usually open heart surgery is the only way to correct the problem, but for some patients, that's just too dangerous. In tonight's Woman's Doctor, a new procedure is helping those high-risk patients get the replacement they need. 93-year-old Ethel Eaton loves getting around, especially with her grandchildren. But about a year ago, she was a different person, not feeling well at all.
Really tired, and I would do a little bit of something and I'd have to sit down. Couldn't breathe right.
Mercy Medical Center Dr. Amish Sera says Ethel had severe aortic stenosis from an aging aortic valve worn out from opening and closing with every heartbeat.
As it gets worn out, it gets damaged, and as it heals from being damaged, it becomes very calcified and very hard, and the opening becomes very restricted. And so that can lead to a multitude of symptoms and becomes a mechanical obstruction to flow and requires a mechanical solution to take care of it.
And that mechanical solution? Transcatheter aortic valve replacement, or TAVR. Because for patients like Ethel, traditional open heart surgery is too risky, and often medication alone isn't enough.
This is the valve.
The replacement valve is made of a stainless steel frame on the outside and pig tissue on the inside. During TAVR, the doctor puts a hollow tube called a sheath in an artery through the leg. A balloon is then inserted through the sheath into the blood vessel to the aortic valve. The fluid-filled balloon is then expanded to crack open the old valve to make room for the new aortic valve. And it's all done in about 2 hours.
I guess getting your tonsils out was more pain than that operation that I had. Like I say, I got my second life.
Well, good for her. And Dr. Sera says that TAVR does have its own risks. Stroke and vascular complications are the main ones. That's why he says it's important to go to an experienced cardiac center for screening to make sure that you're a good candidate for the procedure.